It's no secret that metal can proudly claim numerous incredible drummers who have left and continue to leave indelible impressions on the genre and on drumming in general. And while we here at Metal Injection would love to jump into an all-encompassing discussion on metal drumming as a whole, in this video, we're actually going to focus on something a bit more specific, their feet. The double pedals, along with the double bass drum setup in of itself, are an iconic mark, a visual stamp of ownership at live shows, and often the foundation for the heaviest and fastest grooves of nearly every metal band today. The power and function of the double bass, however, has a surprisingly long history that extends further back than metal itself, and that's what we're excited to dive into today. Before we dive into the double pedals, let's pay our respects to the foot-powered heartbeat of every band by going all the way back to the beginning, before the double bass drum setup, and really, even before the modern drum kit as we know it today existed, all the way back to the 1800s, when percussionists were found almost exclusively performing in marching bands and orchestras. For drummers in this era, armed with just their hands, drumsticks, and mallets, there existed virtually no other mechanisms for them to play multiple instruments at the same time. This meant that in order for groups to play different drums and cymbals simultaneously, they would have to hire at least three drummers, one to play the snare drum, one to crash the cymbals, and one to thump on the bass drum. This changed in 1887 when a band leader by the name G.R. Only filed a patent for the very first drum pedal. In his patent application, Only stated that his invention relates to improvements in devices for beating bass drums in orchestras, by which the bass drum and cymbal will be simultaneously tapped or beaten by a single performer. Though it included the core concepts of what would become the modern bass pedal, Only's invention ultimately wasn't very useful. As the desire for innovation in drumming continued to grow throughout the 1800s, more adaptations of Only's drum pedals began to surface. Until the early 1900s, when the concept of double drumming was developed. Double drumming was a method by which drummers would position their bass drums close to the snare drum and at an angle that allowed them to play both drums with their hands. This method of drumming, which was most notably used by New Orleans jazz bands, gave drummers of the era a quick fix for their desire to be able to play more than one drum at a time. From there, countless prototypes for a more effective drum pedal came and went throughout the first decade of the 1900s, until the design for the bass drum pedal as we know it today was patented in 1909 by brothers William and Theobald Ludwig. Ludwig's invention revolutionized drumming, allowing drummers to play faster as well as create more expressive and complex rhythms, ultimately leading to the development of the drum kit as we know it today. All modern bass drum pedals still utilize the mechanics designed by Ludwig. From here, it wasn't long until jazz drummers began to ask, but how can we play the bass drum even faster? And the answer was seemingly obvious. Simply stick another entire bass drum into the mix. And just like that, the first double bass drum setup was born, pioneered by legendary jazz drummer Louis Belson, who famously demonstrated the setup while drumming with the Duke Ellington Orchestra and on his own composition, The Hawk Talks. However, the drum set's role in big band swing groups didn't allow for too much double bass work, so its limited use was usually found only during drum fills and solos. A small number of swing drummers followed Belson's lead and began incorporating double bass setups on occasion, but the concept never caught on, and it remained more of an oddity until the 1960s when the rock scene started to heat up. Let the record show that while his playing may have sounded like it, John Bonham actually didn't use double bass drums much. He was fast enough with one foot as it was. While Bonham may have dabbled with it here and there, one of rock music's earliest drummers to experiment seriously with double bass was Cream's very own Ginger Baker. Baker was also an early pioneer of the drum solo in rock, where he famously incorporated double bass drums into the track Toad, a 5-minute-long drum solo composed by Baker himself from Cream's debut album. In his solos, he was particularly known to incorporate a rhythm that alternated between strokes from each of his hands, followed by his feet, a right-left-foot-foot rhythm.
I play sort of like if you're using two bass drums, if you play a time with one, you can fill in with the other one and it makes a pattern, the two of them together. Yeah, well,
say you're keeping time here, right?
Baker was an experienced jazz drummer before making the shift to rock music, and his early fills and solo elements were sometimes influenced by Sam Woodyard, Duke Ellington's drummer. Outside of his soloing, Ginger Baker was incorporating double bass grooves into Cream's recorded work too, which can be heard on tracks such as White Room. And of course, at the tail end of Sunshine of Your Love. Baker's prominent use of double bass quickly influenced other drummers to do the same, even directly inspiring Keith Moon to adopt the setup for himself. From here, the double bass drums officially became a mainstay in rock music. As rock progressed into the 1970s, the double bass exploded in popularity as drummers began to experiment with them in creative ways. Bill Ward, who sparingly used his double kicks with Black Sabbath, laid out a fast groove on Into the Void. Carmine Appice, performing with Cactus, was among the first to introduce a groovy shuffle pattern on the bass drums. Billy Cobham would go on to crank up the speed of the shuffle technique in his own work. Terry Bozzio was experimenting with more than just two bass drums, which would lead to his revolutionary technique of incorporating melodies with his feet to solo over. And of course, the inimitable Neil Peart, whose unique style blended elements from across genres, from jazz to prog rock. There were, of course, many other notable drummers using double kicks during the same period, but as the 1970s came to an end and the 80s rolled around, we all know what happened. Things got much heavier and much faster. As the 1980s rolled in, it seemed like nearly every rock and metal band was deploying the double bass drums. And as thrash metal crashed onto the scene, the technical importance of having two kicks began to change entirely. While the double bass, up until this point, was more often used during solos, drum fills, and just generally adding pockets of percussive flavor into tracks, thrash drummers started using the double bass as a method of timekeeping, introducing fast, repetitive rhythms that built driving foundations underneath their band's music. When it comes to laying down blisteringly fast double kicks, no drummer would have as much of an influence on the speed of bass drums and metal as Dave Lombardo. Christened the Godfather of double bass by Drummer World, Lombardo shattered barriers on the limits of both the speed and endurance of what drummers had previously thought possible on the bass drums. Drumming for Slayer, his double bass work on Rain and Blood and South of Heaven cemented his influence in metal drumming, ultimately paving the way for extreme metal drummers, as well as influencing the double kick's use in modern metal today. And Enter the 1990s and 2000s, where the double bass continued to flourish as an established approach to rock and metal drumming. This continued growth in popularity was partially thanks to the fast-paced rate of improvements and affordability related to the double pedals, which allowed drummers to play double bass on just a single bass drum. But more than that, these two decades saw the emergence of a new generation of drummers who would build on the footwork of their predecessors in new and increasingly innovative ways. Take a listen. Many of these drummers, of course, are still at work today, and together with younger drummers and emerging metal bands, are continuing to push the boundaries of what their feet are capable of on the bass pedals. We might not know exactly what new innovations the future holds for drumming in metal, but we can rest assured that whatever they may be, the double bass drums will continue to hold an essential place in the pulse of metal bands and the hearts of metalheads everywhere.